In this video, we're going to talk about the pros and cons of wet bass.
Relevant, relatable, and reliable information from full-time RVers.
So Russ, what is an RV wet bath?
So an RV wet bath is a shower and toilet in the same space. It's common on small trailers like ours and Class B vans. First, we're going to talk about the positives of a wet bath.
Well, first you have a place to sit while you shower.
This is true, especially when you're getting older like you and I are.
No, or you shave your legs.
Well, I don't have that issue, but I'll take your word for it. No, it is nice to be able to sit down, especially if you had a long day, and just shower off while you're seated.
One of the things I do like, especially in a small trailer, it takes up a smaller footprint.
Yeah, so that's very important because there's no way we could have a dinette, we could have a kitchen, we could have a refrigerator, we could have a queen size bed, we could have all that storage in there if we didn't have a wet bath. If we had a regular bath, there just wouldn't be any room for any of that.
I'd much rather have the small shower, the small wet bath, than nothing at all.
Yeah. The next positive is it's super easy to clean, trust me.
Like you've ever done that.
Well, I've seen you do it. It looks pretty easy.
There we go. But it does make cleaning up very easy. Just showering everything down. We use a little squeegee type thing and you're done very quickly. Smaller space, quicker to clean.
Yeah, and you know what too? You're taking showers in there all the time, so there's not a whole lot of dusting. You know how dust gets everywhere, especially when we go off-road? In there, the dust gets washed down every time you take a shower.
Well, here's one of the things. You have those fans that are in the bathroom
all
the time, and you're getting that air sucking through there. So if the air is very dusty, we were in Sedona for a while, and that road dust got everywhere and just gets pulled into
right
the
into
RV,
the shower,
and it's everywhere. So it's very easy to clean all that off.
You know, another great thing is that when you're showering, you can just shower the shower down or the wet bath down at the same time, rinse everything. You know, I just rub the walls or take the squeegee or whatever, you know, your toothbrush. I'll do the toilet and stuff. You know, it's nice.
I'm glad you don't clean. Now, there's different times when you come in and your clothes are all wet. You've got a raincoat or winter. You've got all that snowy, wet stuff. You have a nice closet that you can hang things in so that they can drip dry.
Yeah, you know, especially with me, I do a lot of metal detecting, and a lot of times, unlike today, which is absolutely gorgeous, the weather doesn't cooperate with me. So I'm coming in and I've got, you know, rain, or like Carrie mentioned, when we were up in New York, I had snow all over my clothes. And in a small space like that, it's really hard to be able to have a nice place to set those clothes other than outside. But if you have a wet bath, problem solved.
We try to see the positive in everything, but we are now going to be brutally honest about what it's really like to have a wet bath.
Yeah, because it's not all rainbow and sunshine. You know, one of the very first things right off the bat is it's small in there.
Very small.
Yeah, I mean, I can bring both of my arms up, but really, it is tiny inside a wet bath. And ours is a bigger wet bath than I've seen, especially in some of the Class Bs.
We've seen a lot of them where you have either the cut in the roof line or something where you really don't
bend
have
over,
as much.
Yeah.
So you do have a lot of limited space. How we talked about a positive of being able to sit, sometimes that's your only option for showering. So just be aware of that.
And a real truth. You know, another real bad thing is there's absolutely no storage for any, you know, supplies in there.
None. When we got ours, they had this little mesh wall hanging thing that didn't really work very well, but it gave me the idea to really use our vertical space. So we've tackled some of the problems by doing wall-mounted soap dispensers and hooks for towels, things like that, but you really don't have the space that you would have in a regular bathroom.
Yeah, if it weren't for those wall-mounted soap dispensers, we'd have a bottle of conditioner here, a bottle of shampoo here, a bottle of soap
it
there.
It was a juggling act before we got that. I used to line the bottles up on top of the toilet seat, and if I knocked one over, you really don't have a lot of room to bend over in there either, so just saying.
Another downside is there's really not a whole lot of privacy with wet baths.
This is a bigger issue for me than for him, because when you take your shower, you can't keep your dry clothes in there with you, or it's very difficult. I guess maybe you could get a big plastic bag, but you have to come out of the shower area to get your towel or your clothes to change back into, or change in the main area.
I'll tell you, that's my favorite part of your shower. You have to come out and get your clothes. I love it. I just sit there. No, really, she's 100% right. Another thing for me is the privacy thing is you're right there. And on ours, all we have is a little bit of plexiglass between us and the outside world when we're doing our business. And it doesn't even run the full length. You know, up top, there's
ventilation.
Yeah, so privacy is a big deal.
You always have to remember to dry off the floor when you're done your shower.
Yeah, you know, that's a big deal. It's not just the floor, it's the toilet seat. So a lot of times when you get in there and you haven't dried it down completely or it's not completely dry, you're getting your bum wet because you're sitting on a wet toilet seat, which doesn't feel good, even if it's just shower water. A problem I run into is I'm always getting my socks wet because, you know, it's back in the corner or something. I don't see the water. Bam, I get my socks wet. And that's a horrible feeling.
Yeah. Oh, well, I've never felt that, Mr. Don't dry off the floor when you get out of the shower.
Oh, well.
Now, conversely, if you wear your shoes into the wet bath, you don't get wet feet, but...
Yeah, the floor just gets nasty, you know.
Really quick.
Yeah, dirty. You know, because you've got that white shower floor pan, and then saying, you know, you're walking in with your slippers or your shoes, and then you're tracking in some dirt from outside or grass. It just doesn't look good, and you've got to wipe that down every single time.
Every time.
Well, Carrie's got to wipe it down every single time. We've got a couple of tips here to tell you how to deal with all those negatives.
It makes it just a little more tolerable, because I think we can both agree that a wet bath is never going to be anybody's first choice.
Correct.
But squeegee is your best friend. Own a squeegee if you have a wet bath.
Yeah, you can clean the mirrors that way, bring all the moisture down, put it into the, you know, and even the stuff on the floor pan, you can just squeegee it right into the drain.
I'll show you how to do that right after we're done.
I've seen you do it a bunch of times, trust me. Piggybacking off that, since it does take wet baths a little time to dry off, it's best to take your showers either first thing in the morning before you go out and have your day, or at the end of the night, because then you've got several hours where it'll sit there and dry. And you know what? Another great thing to do is run that 12 volt fan, because that's pulling air, dry air from outside in, cycling it up and pulling out the moisture. Now, as Carrie already mentioned, mount hooks inside there. Use that vertical space because, it'll clear up all kinds of room inside that small wet bath of yours.
Keeps everything within reach as well. Now for the floor, we've seen a lot of people solve the wet floor problem by having those raised, I don't know if they're cedar, but they're those floor mats that are raised up. That's a fantastic use. Just make sure that you lift that up and clean it out regularly, because you don't want standing water to sit at the bottom of your shower.
Yeah, so I've seen cedar planks be used, and I've also seen people use little plastic things.
Perfect.
Are wet baths really that bad? And to be honest, I say they're really not that bad. They're a blessing. I can't tell you how priceless it is to have a nice place to take a shower at the end of a long day, especially when you're boondocking like we like to do.
How's your shower?
Oh, it was good. Or you're at a campground that doesn't have the cleanest bathrooms and you just don't want to go in there.
You're forgetting, even in route, you don't have to use the restrooms when you're traveling at rest stops either.
That's right.
So even just having that, it's still 100 times better than those other options. I will take it any day.
So you stuck around to the end. Thank you so much. And for you, we've got a bonus.
Bonus. We're gonna try something that supposedly only women can do and men cannot. Russ and I are gonna give it a shot. Now what you have to do is stand up against the wall, take two small steps back, bend forward and have your head touch the wall. Grab a chair, and then try to stand up. Now Russ's turn. Stand up. Come on. Come on.
I can't do it. I guess not.
Was Carrie right?
Yes, you were right.